Bismillah walhamdulillah. My dear sisters and my brothers, assalamu alaikum and welcome to Under 9 Minutes, part number 5. And today we will deal about those companions that we are told have been given the good news that they are of the people of paradise, like Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, and so on and so forth. And you hear that a lot these days, that there are some companions that have been granted entrance to Jannah without any form of accountability of their actions. And these people on Judgment Day, what this means actually is just on Judgment Day, we will stand and wait our accountability and they will be just swifted into paradise like that, without even Allah talking to them or even asking them anything. So these people are in complete religious immunity. So why is this? Well, all this is based on a hadith, as you have guessed by now. You see, all this hadith about the companions being of the dwellers of paradise or giving the good news is text written on the 3rd century. When I say 3rd century, is starting from 200 and up. So the beginning of the 3rd century, right after the death of the messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Man composed those hadith based on that era where they were living. When they were living there, there were a lot of conflicts, so they resulted to this form of text. But that has carried on until our times these days. This belief is not debatable. You cannot debate it at any point in your existence. And if any believer refuses this guarantee, i.e. the guarantee given by the messenger to Abu Bakr, for example, that he is entering Jannah, then there are fatwas on the internet and in our books that if a person, a believer, and I'm not going to say Muslim because the Jewish is Muslim, the Christian is a Muslim, all are Muslims, but we are called believers in the Qur'an because Allah talks to those who believed in the Prophet Muhammad and the Qur'an when Prophet Muhammad died. But anyhow, so these fatwas deal with the believers that actually do not accept that Abu Bakr is of the dwellers of paradise. You see, as if believing in the companions was a pillar of the faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the pillars of faith in the Quran, and he mentioned 5. Believe in Allah, the last day, the books, the angels, and the books. That's it. No decree, no predestination, nothing. But anyhow, the guaranteed proof that are in a hadith, well, as it goes, it's like this, okay? That these man-made hadiths with zero text from the Quran. So the root of these are all based on the hadith. In fact, the Quran completely rejects this type of claims, which makes it absolutely clear that the messenger of Allah, who is nothing but an envoy or a postman to deliver to us the Quran, that is the message to us, we have to understand this, my dear brothers and my sisters, if we want to go back to the Quran and go back to Allah in a very pleasing manner. The Prophet Muhammad, just like Adam, like Ibrahim, like Moses, like any of his brothers, were just doing a job. Allah sends you a message. The means of transportation is a human being to us. Okay, and it's worth saying at this stage that the majority of those given this fake news, i.e. that they're going to be of the dwellers of paradise, were people from Quraysh. 99.90% of the people where the hadith said that this person is going to go to Jannah, and this Abu Bakr is from Quraysh, Umar is from Quraysh, Uthman is from Quraysh, Ali is from Quraysh, Talha is from Quraysh, Zubair is from Quraysh, and I can go on and on and on mentioning the names, that all of them are from Quraysh. And that is a political issue throughout time, but this is not the time for that. You will also find that the Ansar, the people of Al-Madinah, ended up with nothing. They did everything to support the messenger and Al-Islam, and they ended up with nothing. Furthermore, the wives of the messenger. There is not a single hadith that tells Aisha she is of the dwellers of paradise. Why? Because Aisha was not in agreement with Umar, was not in agreement with Uthman, was not in agreement with Ali, and of course, she doesn't deserve paradise per se. So as you can see here, so those good news of certain people that they will enter paradise, like Umar and Abu Bakr and so on and so forth, and others, are based mainly because A, they are from Quraysh, 2, they are male, and 3, they all played an active part in the history of Muslims. Okay? Now, the truth of the matter is, when Allah sent the Prophet Muhammad as a messenger, Allah used this human to be the link between Allah and the human. Like a phone at your home or the telephone that you get, it's the tools with which you communicate with the other parts or parties throughout the world, right? Well, the same thing for a messenger. They are just tools that Allah used. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the Qur'an or any other books of revelation, the Torah, the Gospel, and so on and so forth, to Jibreel. And as I said before, Jibreel is not an angel. And I will dedicate in under 9 minutes talk about Jibreel, because Jibreel is not an angel. Jibreel alayhi salam is a holy spirit. It's completely different than the other angels. And Jibreel has got two main functions. One is deliver al-wahi, the revelation, and two, give life. And I'll deal with that later on. Okay? But anyhow, the Quran is from Allah, through Jibreel, through Muhammad, and unto us. And Muhammad again and Jibreel are just but tools. Okay? So the messenger didn't come on earth to tell us who was going to go, who was going to succeed and go to Jannah, who is going to fail and go to hellfire. His job is not this. His job is just to convey the Quran to us. I will mention a couple ayat here because there are an infinite number, so to speak, like exaggeration, but there is a huge number of ayat in the Quran that actually talk that the companions are very fallible. And there is a huge minority of them, a little minority that Allah is pleased with them. The majority of them aren't. If I go by the statistical words of the seerah or the books of history, they say that the companions at the death of the messenger were around 120,000. 120,000 companions. Okay, with a difference of opinion between what makes a companion and what makes not a companion, but we're just going to go with the number, okay? But in the Quran, those that Allah is pleased with them are nothing else but 1,400 people. These people were those who went with the messenger for the Umrah, and then they had the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah and so on and so forth. So 120,000 people. In the sight of our scholars, all of these people are companions. The Quran, on the other hand, even though it did not define the number, but those upon whom Allah is pleased are only 100 and about, not more, like 105,000, nothing more than that. Okay, so here we are in the middle of all this turmoil. But anyhow, let me tell you why the messenger could never ever know that where Abu Bakr is gonna end up, in paradise or in hellfire. And the main reason is the messenger of Allah does not know anything about the future. Again, I will repeat, the messenger knows nothing about what is going to be done in the future, either to himself or his followers. And this is extremely important. Okay, I will stop here because we're coming up to the 9 minutes, and I'll carry on in the next one, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.